Hey guys, welcome to the video, and today we have the Abyssal Lock tanking Shadowfang Keep. Now, Warlock is a pretty damn good tank, but there are some things to keep in mind when you're making your own Abyssal Lock, especially when it comes to Shadowfang. I hope you enjoy the video. Found someone who will join us. Yeah, make me a leader, perfect.
Why did they take me out of Wolf form?
What? Oh, whenever you can't cast spells when you're in wolf form. So if you used any ability, that
I did not.
Okay, well then it, or if you click it again, I don't know.
I didn't click it again.
Oh, I don't know, Alex. Oh, maybe are you? Did you go inside the keep?
No, but when I approach it, it kicks me out of it.
Okay, yeah. So technically, you can only use Ghost Wolf while outside. You can't use it indoors. So,
well, I'm still outside.
Well, I guess it means the freaking...
Well, you're under these two beams, so that means you're inside.
It's all a courtesy thing. Hey, let's summon. Shadowfang Moonwalkers. Now, these Worgens cast an anti-magic shield on themselves. All you have to do is focus on Searing Pains before the shield goes up, and you'll have plenty of threat. Now, something to keep in mind is that any dots put on them or channeling spells done before the shield is up will still affect them. All right, Michael Jackson Moonwalker doing anti-magic shields.
Yep.
Justin, you got someone tied up in the background?
No, I'm watching TikTok.
Beat him to hell.
Do you think whining was the signal? Hey, whoa, easy. We should wait a second or so. Hey, guys, come on. Oh, well.
Shadowfang Dark Souls. Now, these Worgen are completely immune to shadow damage, which really isn't that big of a deal when you're tanking as a warlock, except for your corruption, any of your curses, and shadow bolts will do absolutely nothing. Wailing Guardsmen. Now, these ghosts have an ability called Screams of the Past. It's a 5-second AoE silence. Now, you should have your Booberry tank them away from the group, but if you can't do that, just spam Searing Pain before they get in close combat range with your Warlock. These are definitely more difficult mobs to deal with as a Warlock. The last mobs that I want to chat about are the Fel Steeds and Shadow Chargers. Now, they do an AoE stomp that stuns. You should pull them with your Warlock, send your pet in, and use his Suffering ability to grab threat on all of them. Then just blow them up. Baron Silverlane. Send your pet in, use Curse of Weakness, and on to the next one. Commander Springvale. Now, the fifth member of our group happened to be a little too low level to walk in the room without aggroing the boss. Ideally, how you'd want to do this fight is have a kill target and one of the Wailing Guardsmen. Send your pet after the other Wailing Guardsman. As soon as he uses Torment, then send him after the boss. At the same time, you'll be using Searing Pain on the primary kill target. Once the adds are dead, focus down the boss. That got a little hairy there for a second. Oh wow, that's a good upgrade right there. Odo the Blind Watcher. Send your booberry after the boss while you focus threat on the bats. Once the bats are dead, focus down the boss, and don't forget to spread out your curse of weaknesses. Spawn. He drops a sword that's kind of awful. It's cool though. It always made me think of like a two-handed sword wielding healing paladin or something.
It's like incredibly specific.
I really don't have that great of pet control. We have yet to be able to beat this fight when the entire room gets pulled. Sorry, that all kinds of weird. Oh, here they all come.
How'd that happen?
I'd run up here, guys. Alex, get away from there. Fear if you can, Sarah. Well, we haven't been able to beat that fight. That's a really tough fight. Snuffing out Fenris the Devourer. Now, send your pet in first. Once you pull threat, you can sacrifice your Voidwalker for that absorb shield. Was it needed for this fight? Probably not. But just make sure you resummon your pet before Arguel summons his own Voidwalkers.
Forget the book.
Oh, Sarah got the sneaky little book while the fight was happening.
No, I waited till he died.
I was really thinking about doing it. Alright, now we're going to focus on the Houndmaster. Have the DPS take down the non-elite warg while you focus on the other three. Once battle starts, the other wargs will run across the room. Send your blueberry after one of them while you focus on the other two. Make sure you are always using Curse of Weakness to mitigate damage. Once all the wargs are dead, the master's called. Send your pet after the boss and have him hold it as long as he can. Once you pull threat, you can sacrifice, but honestly, as you get more points in demonology, you want to use that only as a last resort. I can probably see why we're... Technically, we have one guy that can't do any damage on these, and then even Justin and you guys are a little lower than these guys are.
I'm doing fine.
No, I know, but I mean, you still are weaker than if you were two levels higher or something. But that makes sense. Well, you know.
It does make sense.
makes way too much sense. Defeating Archmage Argul. Now, this fight can be fairly difficult if you don't have enough DPS. You're going to send your pet in first. I told Bleak Codex not to heal my pet, because this is a great fight to use Sacrifice. Okay, that was weird. He mind-controlled my pet, so I could sacrifice him. Once your pet absorbs the first few Shadow Bolts, go ahead and use Sacrifice. By that time, you should already have your dots on the boss and be spamming Searing Pain. The healer should have no issues keeping you alive until you change into a Worgen. At that point, any of your DPS should try to line of sight the boss to mitigate damage. Most others can't take damage quite as well as the Abyssal Lock. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video, and next up, the Abyssal Lock is heading to Stormwind City to see the Stockades. There we go.
Sweet.
We lost someone right away. Whose role is that? Just...
I jumped down to try and line inside him, and he hit me with a Shadow Bolt as soon as I jumped down and killed me.
Yeah, he hits pretty damn hard.
How many has this guy have?
Thank you, guys.